गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास। टुडे वी आर मूविंग टुवर्ड द लास्ट टॉपिक फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर, दैट इज अ डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन। एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द वर्बल कम्युनिकेशन, रिटन कम्युनिकेशन एंड डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द बिगिनिंग, दैट इज द डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन द फॉर्मल एंड इनफॉर्मल कम्युनिकेशन। So here are the lists of 12 differentiate between the formal and informal communication. You have to go through with the subject, that is definition. What is the definition for formal communication and informal communication? Afterwards, the second point is flexibility. Formal communication is not flexible, but informal is flexible. That means we can change at any time. Afterward, degree of control, evidence, discipline, flow of information, speed, secrecy, rumor, distortion, time. Formal communication, it is a time consuming. So if you talk about the time, formal communication is a time consuming, but informal communication less time to take in for the transmitting information. In formal communication, they take less time. Misunderstanding. In case of formal communication, Kausen, there is almost no chance of misunderstanding. But at the same time, in informal communication, there is a lack of chance of misunderstanding. Now, the 13th point, that is cost. It is expensive. It is less expensive than formal communication. And lastly, mistakes. An official discipline is maintained chance of mistake is very low. On the other hand, as strict rules are not followed, then the possibilities of mistake is very high. Now let's discuss verbal communication. Means verbal communication skills refer to any noise or sound you make when you are trying to get a message across to another person. Similarly, I am trying to give you the message or trying to explain you this topic. This is also a verbal communication. For example, here is example is also given, saying, do you know the what time it is? It is a verbal communication. If the reply of this question is it is a verbal communication. So there is no written work, then it is called an verbal communication. What is non-verbal communication in business? So in one words we can describe non-verbal communication, that is communication without words. Without any words we can say a non-verbal communication. So you can see the some diagrams over there, that is a sign of confidence, relax, worthy, restraint. So sometime we don't use any word, just an facial expression, an eye expression, touch and voice of tone. So these things we use it, this is called an verbal communication. There is nothing about the written and nothing about the voice, any words. So this is simply we can say this is all about expression. Now written communication. Written sign or symbol are used to communicate. A written message may be printed or handwritten. So all this we use in a written form, either in a computer or by your hand. All these written forms are called an written communication. So in this you will find some examples also, that is email, letter, reports, all these are a written communication. What is corporate communication? Corporate communication includes advertising, marketing communication, marketing and public
relations. After discussing,
but they all function under a managed perspective.
After discussing so the different mood
this
of
is a type communication.
Now
where
we are going to discuss the
company wants to
effective
express or
means
advertise
what are the
their
limitations
products
of effective
like marketing, advertising, public relation. All these are corporate communication.
So we have discussed the different types of communications. Now it's time to discuss the barriers to effective communications. Means what are the limitations of the effective communication? Barriers to effective communications. So here are the list for the barriers, that is physical barriers, organizational barrier, cultural barriers. In cultural barrier means if you go to China, it is difficult to talk with the people because they use Chinese language and we have a different problem with talking with Chinese. Then language barriers, channel barriers, interpersonal barriers, individual barriers, attitudinal barriers, listening barriers, and lastly barriers while speaking. So these are the many barriers which affect the communication between the two people or the two companies. So if there is barriers or limitations, we have to find the measure to remove these barriers. So here are the measures, that is close proximity. Means if the department and sub departments are in close proximity, the problem arising due to physical distance may be curbed. Other one is other parties' perspective. One party in the communication process should make efforts to view things from the other party's perspective too. With this, the perceptual difference can be mitigated to get certain text. Next one is psychology of an individual. Barrier arise due to the physical psychological of an individual or their emotional ups and down swing necessarily have to be curbed by the concerned person only. Afterwards, partly of expression. Means when communicating with a people of a different culture, it is important to know their uses of non-verbal communication. Means how to greet them. Afterwards, proper language. It should be made sure that the two parties understand the language of communication. Interpreters can also help where difference in language do exist. Afterwards, proper encoding. Means the sender should take a special care while encoding the message so that wrong grammar use, misconstructions and absence from the message delivery are also uses of words should be done after considering the understanding level of the receiver. So it is important to use that much language, that type of language which the receivers can understand. And lastly, psychological discomfort. If possible, a person should avoid communicating when in someone physically physiological discomfort. For people with visual and hearing impairment, some aid should be organized before communication session. Thank you, class. Just complete your work by today only and send it in this given mail ID.